I'm coming to fight, man. I'm prepared for 12 rounds. It's just a matter of time.
Maul, would you say it's safe to say your last performance against Derry Vianchenko was your most complete performance of your career?
A fighter like Montiel is more challenging to get in there and get the job done real clean and real, you know, spliffy. Because if I look bad against a guy like this, then they'll take away from the Derry Vianchenko fight. But yeah, up to date, that was a hard fight. I made nice work of it, and you know, on to the next one.
You've been outspoken about wanting to unify at 160 before moving up. Obviously, you want the Canelo fight, but you know, people who have been following the sport know that, you know, Triple G's really just been ducking you for the better part of the last 3 years. Do you really expect to land that fight with him or Andrade?
You know, I got the belt. It's champions fight champions. We unify. You know, if not, we not just gonna sit back and just say lack of nothing. You know, and Those guys that have the belt, like Triple G and Canelo and Andrade, you know, the belt's out there, so eventually it'll happen. I'm not in a rush. I'm young. I'm still having fun. I'm enjoying what I do best.
But why would Triple G, at the later portion of his career, fight a young, hungry champion yourself?
I mean, that's a good question. You should ask him that, because I honestly don't know. If he wants this WBC, I have it. It's over here. It's open. I'm ready to fight.
Most definitely, Jermall. What'd you make of Canelo's last performance against Billy Joe?
I mean, it was, you know, Canelo being Canelo. Seemed like Billy Joe's game plan wasn't in there to go get his eye broke, but Canelo landed a good shot, and look, it's boxing, right?
Did you see any vulnerabilities in Canelo, and how do you feel you match up against him?
I mean, I think I match up well with him. You know, I'm at 160 pounds. Canelo is at 168, 175. He's steady moving up. If he ever decides to come back down, maybe we can fight for the WBC legendary belt that they gave him.
And you said, you've been on record saying you'll go up to 168 right now because the fight fans want to see that fight.
Right. I mean, if the fight makes more sense for me to go up and fight Canelo at 168, yes, I'm open for it. But right now, I got a task at hand with Montiel. I'm not thinking about Canelo right now. I'm thinking about, you know, getting the job done, and then, you know, we'll go from there.
Last question for me. What'd you make of Boo Boo Andre, the confrontation post-fight press conference at Canelo, trying to?
I mean, guys, you know, want clout, want attention. Sometimes it's not good for them, but they still do it. But, you know, I mean, that guy's just, I don't know what to say about him. I mean, he needs to do things like that to get himself relevant, you know, because nobody cared for his fights. He's in a bad situation, you know, and then you let alone, like Canelo said, he's a horrible fighter. I mean, he's a horrible fighter.
Thanks, Jermall. Appreciate you.
All right, Jermall. Russell Davis reporting for ES News. Just to piggyback off of what the other gentleman said, is that a firm confirmation that you're going to be staying at 160, or, you know, would you consider, are you considering moving up to 168 to see Canelo?
I'm campaigning at 160 pounds right now. Mm-hmm. I'm the WBC middleweight champion at 160 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
If we can get the fight at a catch weight, mm-hmm, and for some reason keep the strap, you know, or put the strap online, I'm down for any of that. You know, I want to unify like my twin brother. Mm-hmm. I'm just still chasing my dream, you know. There's so much ahead of me. Right now, I'm focused on Montiel. Mm-hmm. I'm not focused on Canelo, GGG, or anybody else.
Right.
I have some at hand, so that's what I'm focused on, man.
I see. Okay. Also, you talked recently about facing Triple G. Just to set the record straight, was there an offer ever sent to you?
No offer. There hasn't been no paperwork on it. Not an email, mm-hmm, not a text message. I haven't spoke to GGG or his camp. Mm-hmm. My camp have reached out to him to send him contracts, but we haven't got nothing back. And so right now, we have to campaign at 160, and that's where we'll stay at. But I'm big enough to make whatever weight division they want me to, mm-hmm, make.
Okay. Also, Eddie Hearn is also has put information out there saying that he sent various offers to fight Andrade. Do you care to give us any feedback on that or confirmation as to what happened in that regard?
He's reached out to my camp, and we've reached back out to him. But if the offer doesn't make sense, you know, we the champ. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't care to see Andrade fight. They care to see Jermall Charlo fight.
Right.
Who is Jermall Charlo going to defend his WBC against?
Mm-hmm.
And right now, it's Montiel. And that's what we got at hand. We're not sleeping on him.
Mm-hmm.
We got to be well prepared for him. Obviously, his offer didn't make sense, you know. Mm-hmm.
When you say make sense?
It makes sense.
Money.
Right.
Okay.
All right. So if it don't make money, it don't make sense. And
right.
then at the end of the day, I'm here to feed my family, and I'm not worried about Andrade. I'm not worried about Golovkin. I'm not worried about Canelo, honestly. I'm just here to fight the best in the world. If they want to fight me, then I'm here.
Do you care to confirm what that number was or what that offer was?
I don't even know the offer. I don't even remember. I don't think he actually gave a. He's that random number, whatever he that. None of that stuff is true, man. If you don't hear from me, it's not real. Because I'm vocal. I'll tell you exactly what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently it didn't make sense. And whatever he's getting and whatever he's trying to offer, I'm already making it.
Okay. Thank you very much, Ma.
What is your sense of...